Hello, this is Paul from Fossil Tech. In this lecture, we're going to deal with the second type of improper integrand, which is discontinuous integrand. The first type we did, which is the infinite interval, right? So this time the interval is finite. Look at it, we have three cases, okay? We have three definitions. The first case is going to do integration for the function from A to B. Is a finite interval, okay, it's not a good. The interval, if we look at AB, is not a good to infinity. Look at this is a normal case, right, the normal definite. However, it is not a normal, okay, it's not a proper, it's a improper. Why? Because look at B is discontinuous. We cannot take a value at B. The function this time goes to infinity, okay. Usually this type, discontinuous function at here, we have another name called infinitely, right? Infinitely discontinuous, okay? Infinitely discontinuous, because the value of the function goes to infinity. We cannot have a value at B. So you can imagine how to define, okay? How to define this? We have a basic, because this is not a normal, okay? We cannot define as the original, okay, as the normal, because of what? The area we cannot see the completely, okay, as the value goes to B very close, the height of the function, you know, goes to infinity. How do you define? We define it this way. The idea is still similar as the improper of the type of infinite interval. We do this and pick a variable t. So we'll stop at here. From A to T, we do integration first to find the area. And then what to do? And to increase T, that T approach B, of course, is from the left side. And then define as the limit. Okay. Of course, it's still the same. If the limit exists, what does it mean? The limit, if the limit exists, it means the areas converge. All right, the area converges. And we say the improper integral is convergent, okay? The second case, if the function is here, and the left endpoint A, which is the law case, we go back to the first. The first is the function is discontinuous at the upper limit, right? The second is the function is discontinuous at the lower limit, which is A. So how do you do? And this function goes to infinity. We cut at a t and then find the area first, then at t approach a. Of course, this time is from the right. Do you remember the limit from the right approach a? See, that's the definition for this improper integral. Of course, we have the third case, which is here. If the function is discontinuous, not at the two end, not at the left end, the right end, but in the middle somewhere, we say at c. How to do? So this time, of course, this discontinuous is infinitely discontinuous. This goes to infinity, this going to infinity, or this goes to negative infinity, whatever. So this is improper at the left, right? Can we see from A to C is improper. From C to B is another improper, okay? If both improper converges, add then together is the definition. Can we see from A to B, which is from A to C plus C to B, both are improper, okay? How do you define? The only way is like this. If both converges, and then the third type of improper we call the converge, okay? And the first two type is the basic, okay? If the limit does not exist, we call this improper integral diverge. If the limit exists, we call it both improper integral converges. Okay. I give you only one example because you only need to use the definition, right? Two steps to calculation. First step, find the definite integral from t to b or from a to t. Okay. The second step, take a limit. Because for here, limit is either project from the left limit or the right limit. However, usually it does not matter, okay? These are questions. Can we see? First, look at it. Is this integral is a normal integral? No, not a normal. Why? because when we put the 5 inside the function, we see 5 minus 5 is 0. The bottom goes to 0, 1 out of 0 goes to infinity. Okay, we cannot define at x equal 5, which is discontinuous. Can we see? From here, we simply easy to find this function is discontinuous. Okay. Continuous at x equals 5, right? Which means the first type. The upper limit is not defined or discontinuous, infinitely discontinuous. Two steps, right? Now we follow the definition. Two steps calculation. The first step do definite integral, but we meet t here. The second step take limits, right? Okay. So the definition is use this. The first we put the t here, a variable, and here no change. 5 minus x dx. And the second step that t approach 5 from which side? From the left side, okay, which means left limit. You see, this is the definition. Okay, this is the definition. Of course, this step is the most important. They ask how to deal with this kind of improper integral. Okay. The second now is going to the first step find the definite integral. The second step to limit the calculation. Okay, so we're going to the first. How to do this? Don't worry, this is easy. You don't need to do substitution. Why? Because the integrand is a power function, right? Have you seen kind of power function? Okay, power function. We definitely have the entire derivative directly. So first, I just make this easy to look at, okay, 0 to t. This, if we make it as a power, means the power is this 1/3, which is negative 1/3, right, dx. Now definitely you know this is a power, right, okay. Now easy, directly find the entire derivative. What is the entire derivative? This plus 1 goes 2/3, is 2/3. Okay, so here is 5 minus x raised to the 2/3, right? Another is how to make the coefficient. And this take a divisible is 2/3, but you need to also go to the bottom, which is 3 over 2. This is a chain rule, and the inner function take a divisible is negative 1, so we have a negative here, okay? You're going to verify this exactly the entire derivative. Now goes from 0 to t, find the distance. We're going to find the distance. And the t plug in. Okay, I copy this again. So what is this? T plug in is that 5 minus t, right? 2/3 the power. And then 0 plug in. 0 plug in is negative, minus negative is plus, okay, plus 3, 2, and then is 5 raised to the power, times 5 raised to the 2/3 power, okay, I will see. This is a constant number, the limit is itself, what is the limit for that, okay, and the limit for that is t approach 5, 5 minus 5 is 0, 0 raised to the 2/3 power is 0. Easy to find that this approach 0, right, this approach 0, which means that we only have one term. The last one is the answer. Okay, let me see. That's very similar as the first one, the first type of improper. Do two steps there. The first find a definite integral. Okay, the second take a limit. That's all. Thank you.